You know, you spoke about Nehru and the fact that he didn't really want to divorce cultural religion from our lives. You know, he had wanted an equal distance of the government from all faiths. But I was asking you that, let's leave Nehru where he was, because, you know, he was like looking at the Muslim community after the pain of partition. There was a kind of reassurance that you were trying to give the minority at that time. I'm asking you, in maybe the last 20 years, you know, that as a congressman, as someone who's been a minority minister, speaking for your party overall, what do you regret not doing about repositioning and rethinking and being agile about the whole Muslim question?
Very difficult to answer this question, because I'll tell you why. Because as I understand, in terms of ideology, I'm certain that our ideology was very sound. And our ideology of syncretic India, of inclusive India, and an ideology in which we didn't see Hindus and Muslims being in conflict. I was quite clear about that. But there were strategic moments in which we may have gone wrong. Now, I think everyone sitting here, if you took a vote, would say that we did a horrible thing with Shah Banu. I would take less than 2 minutes to explain that what we did in Shah Banu was nothing out of the ordinary. And in fact, nobody, the least of all women, can complain about Shah Banu, right? But the fact is, everyone believes that we did something horrible in Shah Banu. Just as some people believe that we did something horrible in the opening of the locks of Babri Masjid. But that was not something that we did. That was not something that we could really have prevented at that time. We tried to do the best that we could to prevent a blow up of what was happening. There were incidents that happened when Mumbai burned, for instance, and Shri Krishna Commission report was established. The commission was established. Shri Krishna went, I believe, quite far to apportion responsibility on the administration and on the police. And people will say we didn't act, we didn't do anything, that we were pussyfooting and so
but,
on.
But Salman, just forgive me for my impatience, yeah. But because, you know, you're now saying that people will say, I'm asking you again and again for it is that you say about, you know, what the Congress could do and did not do.
Tell you, I could easily say that Congress should not have overturned Shah Banu. I mean, that's one answer, because everyone says Shah Banu led to something, and then that led to Babri Masjid, and then that led to Bombay, and then that led to the defeat of the Congress finally in 2014. But that's frankly would not be a truthful answer. To get out of your question quickly, I could say Shah Banu was wrong and I get everybody to clap for me and then say in future we'll never do it again. But the fact is that Shah Banu was not wrong.
Would you explain that in 1 minute?
I will explain that in 1 minute. I said to you I'll explain it in two, but you've asked me to explain it in one. Shah Banu was a case where a woman who had been divorced asked for what was given to her was 153 rupees under the Criminal Procedure Code, which is section 125. It's different now, but at that time it was 153 rupees. What the court said was that, like anyone else, you have a right under the Criminal Procedure Code to get the money, and we are going to give that to you, which is 153 rupees. The Muslim community rose against that and said, look, we have our own system, and you must respect our system and not impose something from the outside. And their theoretical objection was that the Muslim marriage is a contract, and once that contract comes to an end, we can't have the man and the woman in any transaction, including of giving of money. But there has to be an alternative, and there was an alternative. What Mr. Rajiv Gandhi did was to say, what is the alternative that you want? And that alternative was then laid out in the legislation in 1986, which said as follows. You have to give a divorced Muslim woman a quick delivery of the meher, the dawah, that you may not have paid. You have to give her maintenance for 3 months, which is the iddat period. You have to give maintenance to her children. you also have to make provision for her within the 3 months in that period, which in a subsequent Supreme Court judgment was interpreted as a one-time settlement. So one-time settlement, maintenance, meher, the dower. All this was to be given, and what Shabano was giving was given was 153 rupees. And yet everybody thinks that you took away 153 and you gave her nothing.
Yeah, but Salman, I mean, you know, that's the thing that all about, everything about societies is about symbolism. You know, it is about storytelling. And today, if there's one thing that the BJP... So, let me explain
so
my...
So, the answer is we were bad storytellers.
I would say you're terrible storytellers.
We were very bad storytellers, and we remain very bad storytellers. We were bad telling stories about fun and about success, and we are very bad storytellers about tragedy.
Good intention.
About tragedy and failure. We are just bad storytellers. And if somebody was to ask me about what the Congress should do, I would tell them to go and learn to tell stories. That's the difference.